Hi everyone, welcome to a new episode. Go ahead and enjoy that view behind me. I will be enjoying it in real life. Also, a travel blog will be coming up soon, but in the meantime, today we're going to be talking about your security online, specifically two-factor authentication and how that might fail, and more importantly, other solutions. So let's get into it.
Using an additional security layer like 2FA or two-factor authentication is something that I've been recommending since the start of this channel nearly 3 years ago. Now, for those of you who may not know what 2FA is or why it would be recommended, here is a brief review. If you use websites that require you to log in, and if your account there involves sensitive information like your bank details, credit card details, or cryptocurrency wallets, simply using an email and password to protect that information is not the best line of defense. Reason being that typically people use the same passwords over and over again for multiple sites, and oftentimes these passwords can be easy to guess. Now, there's also a threat of phishing attacks, but I'll get into that later on in this video. 2FA is an additional layer of security that comes in the form of an app that you can download on your phone, the most popular being Google's Authenticator app and the Authy app. Both are free and relatively easy to set up. Now, these apps create four-digit codes which reset every 15 seconds or so. If you enable 2FA on a website that allows it, when you log in, you'll then have to reference the code provided by the 2FA app. Now, this means that unless a hacker is in control of your phone at the time of your logging in, they can't gain access to your information. Or at least that used to be the case. Now, there was an article which I tweeted about last week that shows how 2FA isn't as infallible as we'd all hoped. In fact, not only has it been possible to circumvent for a while now, it's now becoming easier to do. I will provide a link to this article down below in the description so that you can dig into it yourself and hopefully learn something new about internet security in the process. But here are a few sentences that I think will open your eyes to how hackers are trying their best to get your information. From the article, to overcome 2FA, attackers need to have their phishing websites function as proxies, forwarding requests on victims' behalf to the legitimate websites and delivering back responses in real time. The final goal is not to obtain only usernames and passwords, but active session tokens, known as session cookies, that the real websites associate with logged-in accounts. Now, these session cookies can be placed inside a browser to access the accounts they've associated with directly without the need to authenticate. So the key takeaway here is that the hackers are still relying on their potential victims to fall for their phishing attempts, to click on their fateful links that ultimately opens your digital door for them to step inside, poke around, and steal everything that they can. I can't make a video about this topic without including how to avoid phishing attempts. Oftentimes, they present as emails that scare you into action. Something has suddenly gone wrong, your information is at risk, and suddenly you need to click a link or respond with your login information like passwords or phone numbers. Oftentimes, they are fake websites with URLs that look nearly identical to the real thing, but are slightly misspelled, or they have the wrong ending like .co instead of .com. You proceed to log in with your information and you've given it all over right to the hacker. Now that is the crux of this problem, the phishing attempts. If you never fall for them, you won't be a victim of them. If you'd like an additional peace of mind, there are other new options that leverage the strength of blockchain technology in your favor to secure your information and enable you to verify your identity, often in ways that are easier than traditional login requirements. Now, if you're interested, check out DigiID, something provided by the Digibyte platform. There's also Hydro Platform's application called Raindrop. Now, both of these are new, meaning that there aren't many websites that have implemented them, but they exist. And there's certainly a need for more options like this to crop up in the future, so keep an eye out for them. Hackers are smart and getting smarter. Your security practices should be improving as well. Keep yourself up to date and keep your information, money, and investments safe.